Hello guys, welcome. My name is Nadreen and welcome to the first video in my sustainable journey with Mutha. So this video was inspired by fellow Mutha host Emily, who also cleared out and decluttered her wardrobe. And I'm going to do exactly the same thing. Basically, this is time for me to begin on a journey to really only keep things in my wardrobe that I love, that I get wear out of, and most of all that just make me feel good when I'm wearing them. So I want to bring guys along this journey. I want to show you all of the things that I'm going to do following this wardrobe declutter and the new space that this will release in my wardrobe. So I hope you guys enjoy the video. So what I plan to do, clear out loads of unused, unworn or rarely worn items from my wardrobe. And this will really encourage me to, instead of purchasing new clothes, to just really maximize and get the cost per wear from the items that I do have. So I will be donating any clothes that I clear out of my wardrobe to my local charity shop, and then doing some really fun and interesting things after that. So please make sure you are subscribed to the Mutha YouTube channel and follow them on Instagram as well to see some of the things I'll be getting up to in the next few months. So we're over at my wardrobe now, which is a tiny IKEA wardrobe that I got God knows how many years ago. But as you can see, it's small anyway, so it doesn't make sense for me to have loads and loads of stuff in it. Okay, so now we're in the actual wardrobe. And as you can see, I've got bags, accessories, and lots of random stuff up here. But in here is the actual problem. So I've got rows and rows of clothes, and I can very much tell you I probably only wear half of what's in here. So we're gonna get rid of some stuff. I think the best way to do it is to take everything out, put it on my bed, and then talk you guys through how many times I wear certain things, what I wear them with, how I style them up, and what I think just needs to go. So as you can see, it's quite a hefty pile on here, and I do have a lot of stuff in the wash as well. So let's have a little think about the different types of outfits I need and pick from those categories which items I think are probably going to be most useful. First of all is this little black dress from Pretty Little Thing. So I've worn this on friends, birthdays, nights out, on holiday, worn it as a top. I've styled it up in so many different ways, and it was only £16. So considering how many times I've worn it, its cost per wear is probably down to like £1. So this is a keeper. So I'm going to put it over there in the keep clubbing pile. Then we've got loads of jeans. Loads of light, a couple of pairs of light wash denim jeans. So I do like these, don't get me wrong, but a girl doesn't need two pairs of light wash denim jeans. So I'm gonna hold on to these because they're actually my favorite. Shirts, white shirts. I don't have a lot of these, and in fact, I actually found this one in my drawers and I hadn't worn it in ages. So I'm not sure, I'm gonna put this in the maybe pile. This black cami top, I wear a lot, especially layering under blazers. So this is a must keep. This will go over in the tops pile. In fact, we make a cami pile because I think I have a few more of those. Another polo neck, and this is just one from Zara, I believe. I think it's a navy blue color, so that's a definite keep. Then this black V-neck jumper. It's like a really light wool from Zara. I will definitely keep because I can use this for layering and just for tucking into jeans. Really nice and simple. Then we've got these dark blue denim jeans, which I'll be honest, I haven't worn loads of late, but dark blue denim jeans is everything that I need in my wardrobe. So these are a keeper for sure. Then we have this skirt from H&M. Now, don't get me wrong, it's absolutely gorgeous, but when I put this on with tights, it just rides up and bunches up. So this is gonna go in the giveaway pile, I'm afraid. Then we've got this black dress, which, to be honest, I don't know if I like it. It's high neck, so it makes my neck look a lot smaller. And frankly, I don't like the fact that the sleeves aren't all the way long. So this is going in the giveaway pile. Then we've got these Pull&Bear jeans. They are flared at the bottom. And I do have a pair from Zara that I wear that I quite like these. But I've not actually worn these yet. And they came, I put them in the wash once and then they just were destroyed. So they're going in the giveaway pile. This skirt, love, get a lot of use out of, but I'm over it. Do you know what I mean? I think there's going to be a lot of items in this declutter that I've got a decent use of, but I'm just over it. Like, I don't want to wear it anymore. And it's just not my style anymore. So this is going to go in the giveaway pile. This blazer holds a dear place in my heart. It is so smart though. Like, it's almost too smart. Like, I don't have anywhere that I would really wear this anymore. I'm really trying to think. And so I'm going to have to make a ruthless decision and give this away. That was hard. This little black dress, very sexy number. I could never give this away. Like, this I always wear as a go-to on a night out. And I need that. I need dresses like that. So I'm going to put that over there. Then you've got this lovely, lovely dress, which is a really good number for like weddings, like friends' weddings, family weddings, where you don't want to do too much or dress up too much, but it's got some fun down the bottom there. So this is a keep for sure. This shirt. I should really be getting way more use out of this shirt. In fact, I should have taken this on holiday with me and I didn't. And I don't know what I was thinking. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this out of the main wardrobe and we're going to put it in the holiday drawer, which sits at the bottom of those chest of drawers. And we have this little number from Pretty Little Thing. Now it's actually supposed to be a dress, but I bought it and frequently wear it as like a long shirt. But one, I'm not great with ironing, as you might have gathered, and two, I just don't wear it enough. I bought it because it looked really nice on another girl that I saw wearing it and it just didn't have the same effect on me. So this is going in the giveaway pile. Now we're getting to the good stuff. Namely, this gorgeous red off-the-shoulder dress. Let me take off the hanger so you guys can really see it. Look at that. So I wore this to a cousin's wedding and it was a showstopper. So this is not going anywhere because I can only imagine there are a few weddings coming up that I could definitely wear this to. So that is a keep. You know, when I really like something, I then go and buy it in another colour. So this one I actually got first. They actually used to make it as like matching separate. So it's got a skirt and then it's got the matching top here. So I'm going to keep these two because I can rotate them out depending on whether it's a summer wedding or a winter wedding. So this would be my summer pick, that would be my winter autumn pick. This dress, I've got a lot of corporate wear in here because I used to work in Canary Wharf and the dress code is very different to my current workplace. It's like very, very done up, pencil skirts, blazers, that sort of thing. So I don't get to wear this at all. So this is going in the giveaway pile. As are these trousers, which are also from that lifetime. They're just these kind of wide leg pants. They're actually even 3/4. So I didn't even wear them that much when I was, you know, dressing up more for work. So those have got to go. This cute skirt, it's very cute, but I don't really get to wear it much. Yeah, it's really hard to get creases out of, so give away. Same goes for this one, but it's almost too short for me right now, so this has got to go. This cami from H&M, I think, is not going anywhere because I always need these for layering up inside of tops and the blazers that I do keep, so this is a keep. This faux fur gilet, right now I'm gonna say is a keep because it's just that time of year, it's that winter weather, and I know if I pop this inside, like for example with this, like this is an outfit that I will probably be wearing quite a bit in the colder months, so I'm gonna say yay to this one. Then we have this blazer from Zara, which with an iron looks amazing, so this is not going anywhere. This dress, this denim dress,
which I need to find a new way to style just to make it a bit more fashion. So I'm thinking I'd love to get like a leather belt that I can just wrap around loads of times with this. But this is from ASOS and the fit on this is so good. So this is definitely staying. In fact, I need to wear this to work more. And we've got this bodysuit from H&M. It's just in this gorgeous chocolate brown colour, long sleeves, ribbed detail, a keeper for sure. This skirt is another example of things that I don't get to wear. So it's just a lovely pencil skirt from H&M. It fits incredibly, like the stretch on this is so good, but where do I wear pencil skirts? Oh, this jumper, NYC jumper, definitely wear this to work on occasion, so this can stay. This skirt, gorgeous number from H&M. Probably got it around the time that I got that checked pattern one as well. But this has to stay because this paired with like just a simple black polo neck. What I haven't started with is a white shirt, which would be a good look. It just works and I've never seen anything like it before. In fact, I think I hauled it and then I didn't keep it and then I went and bought it. So yes, this is a must have. I think I even had it tailored, so she ain't going anywhere. So then we've got this skirt from Zara, which I got in the sale, which was lovely at the time, but I just don't know how to rock this. We've got these pair of wet look denim jeans from Dorothy Perkins. I always get so many compliments when I wear these, but what I need to do is to like get some big knits to wear them with. Otherwise they're just a bit too in your face, but these are a keep for sure. Then we've got this really cute skirt from Mango, actually, a place I don't shop at enough. It is quite hard to get the creases out, but when you do, this skirt is spot on. So this is a keep. Then we've got this incredibly creased but lovely sleeveless trench from Zara, which I don't wear anymore. And the reason I don't wear it is because once it's been washed, it's so hard to get straight again. This is going in the go pile. Ooh, I'm being ruthless today. As is this. This was bought in my Canary Wharf days, but it's just something that I don't like short sleeves. I've realised this about me. No short sleeves unless it's a t-shirt. So I say that I'm actually wearing short sleeves, but like if they're going to be short, I want them to be really short, not like this length. So this is a go. Oh, this skirt. Oh, man. Oh, I do. No, I can't get rid of this. So I'll have like three mini skirts, but this is really cute. If I could find some boots that would go really nicely with these, like some black flat thigh-high boots, this would be a total keep. So I've got these two leather skirts. So this one is slightly longer. I know I use this a lot. And then this one is just a slightly shorter version. Both from H&M, I believe. Are they? Oh, this is from New Look, actually. This is, oh, I think this is Zara. Yeah, this is Zara. I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep this one because these are colours that I know I will use and I will wear often. Hello to this new-ish jumper that got shrunk in the wash. But what I can do with this one is just, well, one, try and stretch it out loads, and two, rock it with that black leather skirt, the midi length one. But love this. This is also from Zara very recently. Interesting one here from H&M, also shrunk in the wash. I don't know how much I love it or how I feel about it, so this is a go. If I don't absolutely have to have it, it doesn't have to stay. This I got very recently and I need to iron, clearly, but this will be a replacement for the other white shirt that I put in the go pile, so this is a keeper. This will go really nicely with that midi length skirt, actually, so this is a keep, I think. Oh, this blazer. Date night. Leather look leggings, black cami on the inside, heels, strappy heels, and this, superb. So this is a keep. This one, on the other hand, is very similar to that one, but it's in a slightly bigger size than I would normally have a blazer in. So I got this in a small. I probably should have got it in an extra small. So what I might do with this one is get it tailored and just brought in. So yeah, but we'll keep it. Then we've got these 11 look leggings, which are also a recent find from Zara, which I'm definitely holding on to because the fit is amazing, and they have these like zips down the middle that you can like bring up if you're wearing heels. So that's those. And the last item is just a black hoodie from my brother's clothing collection, which I just kind of wear at home on cozy days when I'm really just trying to, you know, stay warm. So this is a must keep, and this will go in the casual clothes pile. And that's everything. So let's have a look at what piles I've got on the bed. My final wardrobe. Let me bring you in for a close-up look. As you can see, I've got all my dresses, my casual clothes, bunch of spare hangers, which I'll probably take to the charity shop as well. All of my workwear, so like from skirts to jumpers to tops to shirts to trousers to blazers, gilets and the like. I'm feeling pretty good about this. Let's close the wardrobe and just wrap up our final thoughts. So we have four piles with six items in the skirts pile, four items in the dress pile, three items in the trouser pile, and four items in the jumper slash tops pile. So thank you guys so much for decluttering my wardrobe with me. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please, if there's anything you do after watching this, make sure you subscribe to Mother's channel and join me for the next video along my more sustainable living journey. I've got lots of exciting new content to come up and really excited to share it all with you. Bye!